In this short video, I'll show you three proven methods for reviving your beautiful tree back to its former glory. And the third method is my tried and tested secret trick that works like magic nearly every time. Enjoy the video. If you just got home to find your bonsai going yellow or losing all its leaves, firstly, don't panic. Overreacting could actually worsen the problem. Of course, if the roots got dry, then you need to water it very soon, but don't overwater it, because leafless trees don't need much water, and we don't want to suffocate the roots. And don't use fertilizer until it's recovered, because those salts could cause the roots to lose water back into the soil. And let me call out the obvious. If it's autumn and your tree is deciduous, it'll naturally drop its leaves ready for winter, in which case you don't have to do anything. And be aware that some trees go yellow a long time before others. It can even happen in late summer. Now, before attempting to revive your bonsai, first make sure it is actually still alive. The best way to do this is to scratch off a tiny part of the trunk. If you see green cambium, it means it's still alive. But if you only see brown wood, then it's probably a goner. And you could also try it on another tree of the same species to be sure that the cambium is indeed green on a healthy specimen. Let's have a quick look at what's happening inside the tree. Here's our healthy tree with a full canopy of vigorous foliage. Now, when we talk about the cambium layer, we really mean three layers: the phloem, the cambium, and the xylem. Let's have a closer look at that. The phloem tubes transport down the sugars generated in the leaves, and they also contain chlorophyll, which is why you see them green. The xylem brings water and nutrients up from the roots, and it's not green because it doesn't contain chlorophyll. And the cambium itself is a thin layer of cells between them and is also not green. Now, what happens when the tree's got no leaves? Well, you don't see the phloem because nothing's getting transported down from the branches. However, it is very possible that the cambium is still alive and the xylem still able to transport up water. So that being the case, we just need to give the tree some time and the right conditions to bud out again. And there's another whiteboard in just a minute, so keep watching to see what the right conditions are. And now, onto the tree revival tips. Inspect the tree closely for insect infestations or fungal infections. If you see scale insects, mealybugs, or spider mites, these are all wickedly elusive, and even if you remove all the visible insects, their eggs and larvae are still in crevices all over your tree. So you need to use an insecticide like neem oil every week for 4 weeks to ensure that as eggs hatch, the larvae can't reach maturity and so can't lay any more eggs. And here's a related tip. Pinch all the flowers off a suffering bonsai because they attract insects. And besides, we want all the tree's energy to go to leaf and stem growth to help recovery. If it's a fungal infection, like mildew, use a plant-friendly fungicide. Whether you use insecticide or fungicide, be sure to follow the instructions on the packaging. And if your bonsai loses more leaves during either treatment, don't worry, we'll catch that with my third tip in just a minute. The second tip is to check if root issues are causing the decline. If you water and it doesn't easily drain through the soil, two things could be wrong. It might be root bound, or the water could be stagnant and slowly rotting the roots. So if it's springtime, you need to repot, trim the long roots and remove the rotten roots. But in late summer or autumn or winter, you might need to perform emergency slip potting to avoid disturbing the roots. Always use granular soil for good drainage and strong root growth, ensuring the best conditions for your tree to recover. Oh yeah, and if it's got moss on it, keep that on in your slip pot because the roots could be growing up into the moss. And here it is, the third and single most successful tip. Place a clear plastic bag over the entire tree to keep the humidity close to 100%. This virtually stops the remaining healthy leaves from losing water through transpiration and encourages your tree to push out new buds. Spray water into the bag occasionally and keep the bonsai in a bright place, but not in direct sunlight. And to understand why this works so well, we need to understand transpiration. Transpiration is a bit like the leaf breathing through the stomata. Now, what happens to the leaf in the heat of the sun? Well, leaves are not just solar panels, but they're also the cooling system for the tree. They suck up loads of water, and most of it evaporates off to cool the leaf down, and to cool the water that goes back down the phloem. So here's the key point. To revive our tree, we need to greatly reduce the amount of water that the leaves evaporate off in transpiration, because the roots and xylem might not be able to supply enough water. And to do this, we need to keep the humidity as close to 100% as we can. Hence the plastic bag with water misted inside. We keep it in a bright place, but not in the direct sunlight, so it doesn't get too hot. And a quick spray of fungicide in the bag will help prevent mould. Even if you think your bonsai's dead, keep the plastic bag on for several months, watering lightly. Sometimes you'll be pleasantly surprised by a new shoot, even when all hope seems lost. In conclusion, whether you use insecticide, fungicide, repotting or slip potting, I always recommend the plastic bag trick. Remember, patience is key and every tree has its own timeline for recovery, so don't give up hope. Now you know how to revive your bonsai. So to keep it healthy and vigorous forever, make sure to watch this video next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.